It's the kind of beat that go.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Joey, and today we're here with some epic gameplay. Now what we're going to be here for is we're going to be doing a map breakdown for you guys so you guys can understand what you guys want to bring along on these different maps, because every single map has a different group of zombies that are going to be coming at you, and I want you guys to be the most prepared you can possibly be for this. So what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be going through another map on our little map series or whatever, and see what we can do, guys. So we did San Francisco already, and I wanted to do, just move on to the next place, our next obstacle in the road. And I'm not exactly sure what order it is because it's been a while since I played in the beginning. But I'm going to go to New Orleans next because that's just the next one on my list. So that's what we're going to roll with. So I'm just going to autofill, bring along whatever. And I'm just going to take a look at it, break it down, and then I'll tell you what troops we're going to bring along. So I'm just going to roll with that. That's fine. So let's just check it out on hard. It'll give us a good look at it. And yes, I am wearing this exact same sweatshirt. It's amazing. It's so comfy. You guys don't even understand. All right, so with this loadout, we have a ton of walls, which is actually perfect for what's coming at us. Now, what we're seeing here is a lot of runners and delivery men, and those can all be huge problems when it comes to low damage people. But a good thing to have here is this is actually a perfect setup right here. Now, first off, if you have a machine gunner, anything like that, it's going to have a perfect spot right behind this wall right here. And we actually have the ability to move the flag right over there. So that also gives a good line of sight of that pad. But what we're going to do is we're going to use things like gunslingers, machine gunners, mercenaries, and snipers. These are going to be the perfect units that you're going to be wanting to bring along with you on this specific map. Now, especially over here, this is a very large straightaway. And what we can do here is we can throw some right along this area right here, this pad. We can be able to use some like fire chiefs and stuff like that. Kind of like the meat, the brutes. The big guys with a lot of health, and that's just going to help us to kind of protect the guys in the background, which are going to be dealing most of the damage. So what we could do is we could easily just throw down some lumberjacks, some fire chiefs, and then maybe an EMT, and then maybe throw in a mercenary. But then back here, maybe we could throw in some sharpshooters, and if you have one, I'd definitely throw in a machine gunner. It's just going to help out, move those guys up a little bit closer so they can get a better view of the pad, see it, cause damage, and that should be good because we want to keep those the runners and the delivery man as far back as possible so they're not getting too up and close and personal with our guys. So that's basically right there. That's a pretty solid layout right there. I mean, it's not the best, but it could definitely be tweaked to your personal preference on what you guys want to bring along, because for me, my mercenaries are at such a high level that they can really just wipe out these drones and guys pretty easily without causing too much damage. Got a wide spread, and it's really good, but when you're on these lower levels, you guys aren't as powerful and you got to deal with a little bit more powerful troops. But I think you're definitely going to bring along some snipers. If you have a machine gunner, I'd go for it. Let's see how this holds up right here. So first, we're going to have some runners. Now, coming right off the pad, those snipers are able to take them out really quickly, no problem. And that prevents them from getting too close to our people. That's perfect. And the machine gunner, just wiping out people. Yeah, I mean, if you got a machine gunner, it's just going to clear everything out and make everything a lot easier. But if you don't have one, a good thing to have is to have this actual like group here. Now these snipers are going to help get those first guys, because the runners, actually, if we move these guys back a little bit, this is going to be good, because the runners and delivery men, they're going to push ahead of these guys, and that way you're going to be able to take them out a little bit faster. It's going to be a lot better. See, as you can see, they're charging ahead of all those drones, and the snipers are able to pick them off so they don't get close and you don't have to deal with them. Now over here, I didn't put anything, so we're not really looking at that, so just kind of doing with their thing over there. But as you can see, these snipers are able to pick off these runners because they're charging ahead, which is very, very, very good for you. But anywho, let's see if we can save this raid, see if it's still possible. Let's bring along some people, throw in some mercs here, and we're going to see if we can possibly still win this raid with what we have right here. So I'm just going to throw in some commandos here, throw in some gunslingers over here. This pad over here is locked down. So as you can see, snipers pick off that delivery man, no problem whatsoever. All right, so we're actually still managed to take this out pretty well. Stem this up a little bit, and I think we might be able to still win this even without paying attention, but that's just because my guys are so high level and it's only on hard. But anyway, I think the main thing going on is definitely gonna need some snipers, gonna need some fire chiefs, lumberjacks, your choice, and mercenaries, gunslingers. I think that's the best thing you're gonna wanna bring. I mean, as you can see, the snipers and the machine gunner did perfectly. They're beautiful, it was awesome. But that's basically what I wanna bring, so you know, just roll with that, test out, try your own strategy, test mine out. If it works for you, awesome. If not, tweak it a little bit. See what works for you preferably, because so many different loadouts can be used and be successful. So try out what you think is best. Give it a shot. Let me know how your results are, if you feel like it. Slap a like on the video if you enjoyed this, thought it was helpful. Make sure you comment your thoughts. I always love the comments. Love talking with y'all. It's awesome. Tons of fun. But that's going to call it today, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Thanks for watching, guys.